Assalamu alaikum children. Welcome to the science class for the grade 4. Today we are going to start lesson number 10, force, work and energy. At the end of this chapter, you will be able to explain the terms force, work and energy, and you will be able to recognize the importance of simple machine and the types of energy and forces of gravity and friction. Okay children, let's start our lesson. What is force? A force is a push or a pull acting on an object. What is a force? Force is a push or pull acting on an object. Means when we are pushing something or when we are pulling something. Here in this picture you can see this boy is pulling the vegetable cart. Okay. And here this boy is pushing the refrigerator. So here the pushing action and pulling action is taking place, but for this action we need to apply energy. By applying energy only we can move any object. Okay, so study the action in each of the pictures given below and identify each action as push or pull. So here in this picture, what can you see? This boy is pushing or pulling. This is pull. Okay, and this boy is pushing the refrigerator. This action is push. And here this boy is throwing a ball, so this is also push action. Okay, but in every situation they are applying energy. Okay, so we will see now what can a force do. If we apply force with our energy, so what a force can do, what are the things we can do by the force? A force can move an object. When we apply force, then we can move any object. Okay, without pushing something or without pulling something, can we move anything from one place to another place? No, we need to use force. So a force can move an object. A force can stop a moving object. Yes, suppose you are playing football. You can kick the ball with the force, means you are pushing. But if you want to stop the ball, then also force is needed. So force can stop a moving object. When a ball is moving, you can stop it by force. A force can change the shape of an object. How can you do that? If anything which is soft, by applying little force you can change its shape. Okay, and you force can change the speed and direction of a moving object. If something is going this way, you can turn the direction to the other way by using force. Okay children, so these are the things which force can do. Here in this picture you can see a footballer uses force to kick the football away. Yes, here the goalkeeper uses force to stop the football shot towards him. And here you are applying toothpaste on the brush. So we use force to squeeze it. When you want to take out the paste, toothpaste from this packet, so you need to squeeze it. So for squeezing, yes, we need force to squeeze the toothpaste tube. Now we will see forces in nature. In nature, where are the forces we can see? Let us learn about two forces in nature that we experience every day. So in our daily life, we can see gravitational force or gravity and frictional force or friction. So two types of forces we can see in our daily life, that is gravity and friction. Gravitational force and frictional force, two types of forces. See this picture children. Can you just leave the land, leave the earth, and can you fly high in the sky? Can you leave the ground on which you are walking, on which you are standing in this way? Can you just raise up by yourself? No, if you want to do that, the gravity which is present in the earth, it pulls you back. So what is gravity? The force of attraction which is present in the earth naturally. Because of that, everything is moving on the earth, everything is stick to the earth. Like when we throw something, it goes on the land only. It cannot go in the sky if we throw something. How much high you throw something, finally it will come down on the earth only because of gravitational force. Understood? So gravitational force is present naturally in the earth. That's why everything attracts towards the earth. For example, throw a ball high up in the sky. What happens to the ball? It goes higher according to your force and it come back onto the earth. So at first it goes higher. When you throw a ball in the sky, first it goes higher, then it comes down to the ground. It comes down to the ground. Why does it happen? It happened because of gravity. It happened because of gravity. So Earth pulls all objects towards itself with a force called gravitational force. Even the atmospheric layer is present around the earth because of gravitational force only. This air which is present around the earth, it cannot go to the other planets. It cannot leave the area in which it is present naturally because of gravitational force. It is called gravity. It is Earth's gravity that pull back a ball that is thrown up. Even we remain attached to Earth because of Earth's gravity. It prevents us from flying away. We cannot fly whenever we want because this gravitational pull, it attracts and it keeps us stable on it. Okay? So the water in the pond. So more example of gravitational force. The water in the ponds. Why water is not rising up from the ponds and lakes and rivers? Because of the gravitational force, it is it is stick to the land only. It is present on the surface of the land only. It is not going anywhere. In the oceans also. It remains on earth because of gravity. The gravitational force of earth also holds the air that surrounds us. Just now I told you atmosphere is surrounding the earth because of gravitational force. To lift a box, we have to apply a force on it to overcome the force of gravity. So if something which is heavy and which is kept on the earth, why do we need more force to lift it? Because of the gravitational force, the weight of the objects will be less or more. Okay, because of the gravitational force. Okay, children, that's it for today's video. We will continue this lesson with the friction next week in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself. Allah Hafiz.